Good morning, everybody. It is Jamie. Welcome behind the scenes here at Jamie Riddler Studios. It's Wednesday, and that means I am focused on getting the podcast ready for you tomorrow. And tomorrow, I'm bringing you artist Veronica Funk, and she has so much interesting to say. Veronica is so generous with her journey of becoming an artist that I really think you'll enjoy spending time with her. And she recently shared a post about being vulnerable as an artist. It's interesting because the topic of being visible, being exposed, sharing yourself out here in the world has been showing up in the studio quite a bit this week. And so I'm wondering what the message is there. It's interesting because this morning I heard on the radio a story about a young Instagram star, Asena O'Neill, who has just closed all her social media accounts because though she was sharing a life that seemed ideal and dreamy to many people, in fact, she was miserable. And I think there's something really important to pay attention to here. And it's important to pay attention to whether you are in that social media stream or not. Because I think that this issue, the underlying problem, is magnified in social media, that we can see it in social media in the way that we can't in other aspects of our lives because social media is new, relatively, and so we're still looking at it with a relatively fresh eye. But what we're talking about is being disconnected from our spirit. What we're talking about is presenting to the world something other than who we are. Asena did this on social media, but many of us have done this in many parts of our lives. How many of us have felt the pain of building relationships based on a self that we are presenting, not the self of who we are? How many of us show up at work and in a way that is expected of us, as opposed to the way that we truly are? That disconnect of ourselves from our lives hurts us. It's damaging. It reinforces to our hearts that there's something wrong with us, that we need to be hidden away. It squishes us into a space too small for us to thrive, too small, in fact, for us to live. I know we may be thinking, okay, but I am not a social media star. Nor do I want to be. And so what do I do about this? If we only allow people to see a perfectly constructed self that is disconnected from the truth, the heart, the raw sinew of our identity, there is danger in that. And if we show up and share the raw sinew of ourselves, there's danger in that too. In the sense of us feeling vulnerable, in the sense of us being unliked or rejected or found uninteresting. That there's a reason we create, that we fabricate this self. We do it to create a sense of safety, and then ultimately we find that it's a cage. And so what do we do? One of the things that we can do, and this is also related then to being around our own real life, our own real people, is create safe environments for ourselves. So find those people that love us just as we are. Find those environments where we fit in, where we feel like, okay, it is okay here to be a geek, or it is okay here to express my anger, or it is okay here to like get excited about beauty or style, whatever it is. So we find a sense of home and safety to where we can actually be exactly how we are. So this is a place where I think the answer is found somewhere between the extreme of hiding and sharing an unfiltered stream with everybody. And all of us will have to dance between those ends to find the place where we feel real, where we feel connected, where we find that balance between independence and connection, between intimacy and selfhood. And it's not easy. There are definitely times where we might share something and then the next day experience what Brené Brown calls a vulnerability hangover. And then there's definitely times where we may walk away from something and feel this horrible sense of not having been true to ourselves. And this is the work of a lifetime. This is not a question that we answer once. It is something about how we dance in the world and how we want to be. What's important here is that the question has been raised and there's something here to think about. Not just about, oh, what those people are doing over there, but what you are going to do here. What you're going to do if you show up on video, what you're going to do if you start a blog, what you're going to share when you click on Instagram or post on Facebook, but also behind those scenes of who are you going to be when you show up at work? How are you going to be when you first start dating? How are you going to be with your children? What is that balance for you between raw, unfiltered self and highly presentational self? We'll all have different answers, and it will take some time and probably some errors on either side for us to discover it. So I hope that gives you something not only interesting but meaningful to play with in your studio today. And remember, your life is your studio. So take this topic out, this topic about authenticity, this topic about exposure, this topic about how you're going to be, how vulnerable, how real, how presentational, how responsive to other people's expectations, how true to your own impulses. Play with that. Explore that. Explore that in your journal. Explore that in your work. Explore that in your interactions with people. Let this be clay on the table for you to feel and connect to and wonder about and chew on and see what you discover. I'll be so curious to hear, see, know what your response is to this question of how we are in the world. I hope that is a great exploration for you in your studio today. I will.